We're doing Richard Schaefer, obviously Parabellum. They do a lot of boxing. One person he works with is a superstar. They say maybe he's the greatest martial artist of all time, John Jones. Let me start with this. There's a lot of talk of Francis Ngannou against Tyson Fury. What do you think about that in boxing?
Well, yes, I'm an advisor to John Jones, who many people call the greatest of all time in MMA. I like to work with those quotes. Floyd Mayweather was another one, and we've seen one today. Regis Broguet is going to be another one of those quotes.
Yeah, he's there against the wall. Yeah.
So John Jones, really, when it comes to MMA, is on top of the top. Now, Francis Ngannou, I watched his fight. You know, it was a good fight. It was a great fight. And I think he's an MMA fighter. And Tyson Fury, and he's, in my opinion, one of the best MMA fighters. He's not exactly as good as John Jones, but he's pretty close, you know. That's why it would be a big fight, John Jones against Francis Ngannou. That's the fight.
Now, in a cage or in a ring?
No, in the cage. In the sport, they
pair. They master, yeah.
Michael Jordan playing baseball or what? Michael Jordan playing hockey or whatever. We don't need to see that. I don't need to see a basketball player playing football or a football player playing basketball. Stay in your lane. Stay in your sport, and I think you do very well. Now with Tyson Fury, you know, we have one of the best heavyweights ever. So what do you think? Who would win that fight? I mean, how can an MMA guy beat a boxer? It won't happen. How can a boxer beat an MMA guy in an MMA, in an octagon? It won't happen either.
We saw James Toney, Randy Couture.
Yeah, it won't happen.
And we saw
either.
Floyd and Connor.
So let's stop with that silliness, because what I think it is, it might, if you promote it as a special event, but not as a fight, it's not a fight. It's an event, it's entertainment, and people want to go and pay 60, 70, 80 bucks, 100 bucks for that, then so be it, you know. But it's not a fight. It's not a fight.
Any news when John will get back in a cage? Or?
Yes, actually. So I've been talking to John on a regular basis, and of course to UFC as well, and UFC brass, particularly, so about that fight. When is he going to be back? We are waiting to find out what is Francis Ngannou going to do. Is he going to fight? Is he going to get surgery? Is like what is his situation? And depending on that, we'll have an opponent for John Jones. And I mean, John Jones' mind is set. He wants to fight for the heavyweight championship of the world. The UFC. Told me that that's exactly what we're going to do, and now it's just a matter of finding out who it will be against.
And I know he's been working with Henry Cejudo. Henry Cejudo is a legend in his own in wrestling. So John already has the box, he already has the other, but he adds wrestling?
Yeah, so I mean, he really, you know, the way John has been preparing, sometimes you have a fighter, a boxer or a UFC guy, move up in a weight class because there is a bigger fight. But John doesn't just move up because there's a big fight. John moved up in a way where he prepared his mind and his body absolutely perfect. It's not about just gaining a lot of weight, gaining the right weight. Gaining, surround yourself with the best nutritionists, with the best strength and conditioning coaches, to really be at your absolute best when you're going to go and challenge for that UFC heavyweight title. And in my opinion, the way he went about it, it sort of like reminds me a bit about Bernard Hopkins, who was a master at preparing himself mentally and physically. And that is how John is. John is mentally and physically ready to fight against for the UFC heavyweight title, and he will win. There's no denying for John Jones. He will be heavyweight champion of the world.
And Richard, I know boxing is crazy these days. Tyson Fury, Dillian Whyte, $41, $42 million per, what do you make of that? I looked at it, I'm like, how are they gonna make the money back?
Well, you know, those who are in the know in boxing, you know, there's like probably, who knows, some side deals being cut and stuff like that. But, you know, irrespective, it's a big number. And if I would be Dillian Whyte and I get 20% of that, $8 million, it's always like I would have signed that contract
yesterday
because you don't screw around with this career.
$8 million.
Life-changing.
And a chance for the
I had the chance, and he's been waiting for so long for that belt, for that chance. So I think it's a great matchup, a huge fight in the UK, but I think for fight fans here in the US, it's an interesting fight as well. It's the heavyweight division. I think Tyson Fury is a global superstar. Tyson Fury has gained a lot of fans here in the United States. He's not just anymore a UK fighter or a UK heavyweight champion. He truly has embraced the global nature of being a global responsibility of being a heavyweight champion of boxing. And I think he's a great ambassador for the sport. So I think there's a lot of fight fans here in the U.S. who are going to watch that fight as well. I can't wait.
A couple more and I'm done. So Ugas is fighting Spence. The winner will have three belts at the 147. You have Estanionis who's fighting for another belt.
No, he's fighting for the regular belt.
The regular belt. I get confused sometimes with the belts, but he's going to be a champion.
Yes.
What do you think about him against the winner of that fight?
Well, so the WBA mandated that Stanionis was the mandatory contender. Stanionis agreed to step aside to allow that Spence Ugas fight to happen. In the same stipulation, the WBA ruled that the winner of Ugas and Spence has to fight the winner of Stanionis and Kutayev, which is for the regular WBA belt. Spence Ugas is for the super belt. So that they eliminate one of those belts, so that there would only be one. So I think it would be a fascinating matchup. I think we're going to have, you've got the flavor Spence, but we saw what Lucas did in the Pacquiao fight. The guy is hungry. He's been waiting all his life for this opportunity. So he's certainly in that fight, and we don't know who Spence is after the eye injury. So I think it's a very, it's not as a clear cut of a Spence wins kind of statement as some people make us believe. I think it's a very competitive fight. And then you're gonna have Aimantis and Dayev on that card, which is gonna be another barn burner, So you're gonna be able to see some of the best heavyweights. Welterweights. And then of course you have the king of the division, the WBO champion, Terence Crawford, there waiting to see what's gonna happen. All roads eventually will lead to him.
What about Crawford and Regis? Would you like that fight one day?
Well, maybe one day, but frankly one day, which sort of like I started to think about after I read the interview from Keith Thurman, where he said he would love to fight Crawford. I said, man, because I know Keith very well.
Great guy.
I promoted many of his fights. He's a great guy, comes across very well, and has a hell of a fighter. So Keith Thurman and Terence Crawford, I would love to see that fight, because that would be fireworks. In an ideal world, I would like to see that sometime later on this year, we're going to have an undisputed welterweight champion. And that's where the sport is going, unifying divisions.
It's amazing.
Fighters want it. And we as fight fans, we want it as well.
A person you know very well and you like him very well, Amir Khan.
Yes.
He's fighting Kell Brook. Eddie Hearn, I'm quoting him, he said, I will not watch that fight. They're both past his prime. What do you think?
Oh, I love to watch that fight, because I think both guys are about at the same level. And that makes it exciting, and that makes it even. And both guys, by the way, are exciting, I still think Amir Khan I promoted many of his fights. Some questions about his chin. But his speed and his skills are really second to none. And that true animosity there between the two of them, there's genuine bad blood. It reminds me a little bit about when I did the Vargas De La Hoya fight. We actually called it bad blood. So this is another bad blood fight. There are, a couple of times a year, you can see these truly bad blood fights. Not made up for hype, not like some genuinely bad blood.
It's not WWE, it's real.
It's genuine bad blood. This is bad as it gets.
What's your prediction for that fight, Richard?
I like to see that fight because of that. It's entertainment. My thing is going to be that Cal is going to have a tough time dealing with the speed of Amir Khan. And I think Amir Khan is going to win unless he gets caught.
So to end this interview, Richard, you've worked with De La Hoya, you've worked with Floyd, you've worked with Broner, with a lot of major names that are very accomplished. What advice do you have for young fighters that are starting their professional career, even amateurs? What does it take to make it and become a superstar?
Well, I think you need to learn from the past. You need to learn from the greats of the past. You need to study what have they done. What have they done to set themselves apart? And I was talking today, I was a little bit early here at the media day. I was talking to a young fighter who approached me and with a similar question. And I think what it is what Mayweather said best, hard work and dedication. No alcohol. By the way, Hopkins too, no alcohol, no drugs. Stay clean, stay sharp, stay focused, hard work and dedication. Once you start surrounding yourself with the wrong people, the wrong women, start drinking, partying, gaining too much weight, taking drugs and stuff like that, it's the beginning of the end. You will never be able to turn that back the clock. But if you are given those blocking talents and skills, and you work on them, and you surround yourself with the right team, the right trainer, the right nutritionist, the right strength and conditioning coach, the sky's the limit.
There you have it. Thank you so much, Richard Schaefer. Make sure to follow with Schaefer_sports and, of course, Parabellum. March 19, their first card in Dubai. Facebook.com/Zekbach reporting.